Okay. Don't kill any policemen, it's definitely not how I roll.
Now, where can they be? The ball is tonight. They must have taken the invitations with them. You wouldn't happen to have seen two carriages pass by here just now?
I did, sir. One was a man.
Yeah, look, screw that. See you around. Okay, there's his carriage.
A private party event. Don't mind if I do.
Didn't kill him. Go, 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 go. Excuse me, gentlemen.
Maybe I haven't been quite as delicate as I could have been, but still.
Who sees me? Yeah, screw you around, man. Why is everyone so suspicious of the random guy in a hood? I don't understand it. Alrighty, time to steal this one.
Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone. is my chance. One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance.
Nicely done, nicely done. In we get.
Now for the invitation. What's this? The swords must be left at the door by order of the Queen. Freddy will know what to do. Easy now.
Be very careful. We want to arrive in style, like he said. Damn it. Fuck it. Tried to thread the needle and it didn't work. Oh, what is it with your disguises, man?
What carriage you got, Nick? Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all. Was it my eyebrows?
Yes. And your face, voice, and body.
I've got an invitation for the Queen's ball tonight. How did you come by that? Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it. Supposing I believe you? Only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy. For God's sake, Freddy. Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done.
You knew you'd come through. Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach. Of course.
What the hell? Oh, it's right up there. It's right there. What am I doing? How did I go all the way up there? That's what I want to know. Okay, so I have a few places here. Yeah. What's with the music? Okay, that one's probably a bit difficult. Okay, this might be a bit difficult. But at this mofo over here. Definitely not. I think my easiest bet's over here. Had my chance and I blew it, damn it. Fuck again.
I must take care not to ruin the uniform.
Fuck. Fucking. Fuck 'em. Fucking hate cops. Douchebags. Oh, God's sakes. I fucking hate these cunts. Fucking hell. Dickheads. Oh God, they're all coming.
go.
I fucking hate the cops in this game. Goddamn, worse than GTA.
Ready? Here I come.
Don't mind like the 50 dead bodies though.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake.
How are the carriages? Oh man. I'm playing fucking Uber.
Come on.
welcome, sir. Your Highness, what a surprise. Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth seized the Punjab from my people, it was a rightful transaction. Britain promised to protect me. By robbing me of my kingdom, Parliament acted in violation of the treaty signed with my family. Here, read it.
I was not aware.
Read. That is all I ask. You are one of the few.
I trust you and your son will enjoy the ball this evening.
He is newly returned from Delhi. I will share what we have discussed. It is most disconcerting.
That proved quite valuable.
Where to now?
St. James's Park.
I noticed Mr. Green did not accompany you.
He has other things to attend to.
Ah, a pity. You two seem to get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow our personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation.
It is. From my father.
Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well, Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Starrick. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily, I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
Father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green mean? He was only a boy when he trained with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
Easy girl.
To Parliament, please. On the double.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
What are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has supplied you with an angling of God knows how long, and now you bite the hand that feeds you?
It is not a matter of money. I cannot stand idle and watch my homeland subjected.
Good day, sir.
May God bless you. Only one more remains. To the Gladstone residence.
Do you miss India?
I remember that my mother smelled of cinnamon. And when she cradled...
I doubt that's what she smelled of if she came from India, am I right?
She fell asleep. When I lost my kingdom, it hurt.
Uber Express.
You are a hard man to pin down.
I know what this is about. Your politics have worn off. Majesty has tired of you. So now you come begging for scraps.
You wound me deeply, sir. My people deserve freedom. I am here to fight for them.
Why did you lose the Punjab? I shall tell you. Your purpose. You were outgunned, outmaneuvered, and simply outclassed. Yes, the Sikhs deserve freedom. I hope with British help and progress, they shall achieve it.
Then why do they cry out for their king?
Britain has a duty to bring about peace. It is an enormous responsibility, and I value your guidance and advice. Much luck, Your Highness.
This is definitely one of the most boring missions of this game. It's bullshit.
Thank you, Miss Ryan. Of
my cause.
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad. Broken, even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us. Cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans. They are located in Buckingham Palace.
Of course they are.
She keeps them among her personal papers in the white drawing room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fry.
And to you, Your Highness.
Yes. Much stealth, such wow. Why so mad? I'm returning the carriage. Returning. Bruv. Just hanging out.